Right, moving back to the stacked double harps, where there's one above the other. This one here is a mini chromatic. It's got a one harmonica and then another harmonica, a semitone above. And the way you shift the air between them is actually to shift the entire mouthpiece. This might seem weird, but in fact it does work because your lips are flexible and you know, you can actually, you know, they will accept the mouthpiece moving between. And these harps allow you to get all your normal bending on the blues harp, but a fully chromatic harmonica. And you can just operate the slider with your thumb. So here's the bottom harp. I think it's a B, or was it? No, it's a D flat, I think, it's a D flat. Now I push the slider in and I get my harmonica, the semitone up, which is a D. And if you move the slider between, you can get a full chromatic scale with slider action. But you can still use all your bends. And it gives you extra ways of getting notes, for instance, like your full draw note. Now you can actually push the slider in and bend down to it from above. Okay, and it just gives you all those chromatic notes which you either have to get by overblowing, valve bending or whatever. Now you can get them with the slider. For instance, the overblow on six, you know, that missing note between. Now you've got it there. The major seventh on hole five, which is normally an overblow, you can actually do it with the slider. And you can do cool little chromatic sort of runs like. Or the same thing down the bottom. Okay, so all those kind of things are possible now. I've got this designed in Suzuki, Hohne and Seidel versions. This is actually a Seidel, and the keys it tells you on the end are A and B flat. Okay, so that's the Seidel version. Now, some of you may be wondering, wow, could this be a chromatic overblow harp? I'd like to think that it can, but that's kind of something that's still to be decided, because I'm not really an overblower. I use some half-valved harmonicas myself, and I think these work better half-valved. Just to kind of show you the possibilities, though, I've got two B harmonicas in this one, two exactly the same marine bands harmonicas in B. One is half-valved, and one is not valved at all. Of course, without valving, then overblows are theoretically possible. So here's, what have we got here? I can tell straight away that's the valved one. So those are the blow notes, okay? You can still bend all your notes. Now if I push the slider in, I'll get the same key harp, but with no valves. Okay, so you can hear on the blow notes, I'll just switch between them, the half-valved one has got a purer sound. So. So the unvalved one is quieter, but it does give a possibility for overblow, so let's try one. Maybe the six-hole overblow. Okay, maybe some overdraws. Okay, now, I'm not a great overblower, and these harps are not as well set up as, you know, really good overblowers would have their harps. But it's sort of the jury's out. I'm very interested to hear what happens if an overblower throws in a couple of their favourite overblow harps into there that are really well set up, and just, you know, see what overblows are possible. If that's possible, then this harp, even if the overblows are not quite as good as on a normal harp, it still gives you the ability to play with overblows, plus use the slider to get the, you know, the alternate versions of the same note. So it just opens up a lot of possibilities. Now, having this air shifting little movable slider gives you other possibilities. So instead of having two harmonicas a semitone apart, as I've just showed you, you can actually have two harps of quite different keys. In this case, this is a Suzuki version. You can see I've got a couple of Suzuki ProMaster units in there, and they're in the keys of G and D, which are the common keys for Irish music. So, for instance, if you wanted to play an Irish set, you could play using your G harmonica, and then just push your thumb, and you go to the D harmonica. So you're playing two diatonic harmonicas selectively, if you like, rather than chromatically. So I've got the I've got the D on the bottom, so I'll push the slider in, and I've got the G on the top. I'll let that out. So I'll play a little bit on the D, and then on the G, and you'll hear what I'm talking about. And then you could go to cross harp. Okay, so it basically allows you to, you know, throw in two harmonicas. Say you've got a song that changes key from, you know, upper tone, for example, from maybe C to D. Well, you could throw an F harp in there, and then a G harp in there. You're playing cross harp in C and D. Now, all of these harps, because there's a longer travel from your lips to the reeds, they are affected by the Helmholtz resonance coupling phenomenon, which I've been going on about in you know, online and articles and stuff for the past few years. It's one of those immutable natural laws which affect free reed instruments, not just harmonicas. But basically, the further away you get from the reed, the more the pitch of the reed is affected. And when you get to your high reeds especially, it can really detune the reeds a lot. So all of these harps work best in a certain range, probably from about, well, the lower the better really. But in your normal range, like from a G harp to about a D harp would be the maximum, you know, the highest one you can use. But between G and C is really the best range of keys for them. Even then, you'll probably find that the very high notes go a bit flat, so they will need to be tweaked and tuned up a little bit in order to get them back into tune. On the D harp, you can really hear the detuning in the top octave. So here that high D is really flat. But you know, these things can be tweaked up. So basically you just have to tweak them as you assemble them. But as I say, I'd recommend with these harps using lower keys. Okay, well this last one here now looks quite similar to the octaharp, but it really isn't. In this case, there's absolutely no valves on the harmonicas behind. You can see that in this case, they're just two Hohner, you know, Hohner Marine Band wooden combs. Now, this is an X-reed harmonica. It's got 40 reeds, you know, 20 reeds on each harp, but only 20 of those reeds are active reeds. The other 20 reeds are X-reeds, or reeds that allow the active reeds to bend. So this is an all-bending X-reed harmonica. It's in the key of C. So here's your scale. Now I can play that scale fully chromatically with bending alone. So you've got all your normal bends. But you can bend all the blow notes, and you can bend all your draw notes up the top end. Here's 8 draw, 9 draw, 10 draw. And also 10 blow, of course. You can can bend seven blows. Okay, so that's fully, it's a fully chromatic, all bending harmonica. The way it works is, it's not immediately apparent, but this upper mouthpiece here is actually separated in two parts, and between them I've got a patent pending little valve strip. It's actually a tiny little piece of plastic. You can sort of see it's a bit more obvious in this one where you've got two different colours. You've got the base and then the top colour. Between them is this tiny little valve strip. So the way it works is that when you blow, the valves to the top harp open, but the valves to the bottom harp close. And the top harp has got sort of your blow reeds, but also your X reeds, which are draw reeds, but they're set with zero gap. So only the blow notes make a noise. But when you want to bend, you use your bend embouchure, the X reed kicks in and gives you that bend. Okay, now when I draw, all the top harmonica is cut off altogether, and the valves open and allow the bottom harmonica to work. And in this case, we've got the draw reeds. And then we've got the blow X reeds, which allow the draw reeds to bend. And you can actually make them bend as much as you want. It all depends on the tuning of the X reed. The one I showed you just before was fully chromatic. This one here is tuned in a tuning that I like to, like to use for melodies. It's a little bit like my Asia bend, but this is a blow draw harp. Okay, so I'll play a little bit of a tune just to show you how it sounds. So this is a little bit of maybe Wayfaring Stranger. And you can hear how I can bend every note to the note below. That's how this is tuned. Okay, so you can hear how expressive it is. This is something that I really love, this kind of all bending capability. And it opens the harmonica up for playing all sorts of interesting music, Asian music, Arabic music, just because you can bend to to every note you want. You can actually retune it to different scales as well. This is kind of like a semi-solo tuning, but it could be in Richter tuning, it could be whatever you like. So this is the Seidel version, and this is tuned for kind of chromatic playing. You can kind of do little blues licks. So this one's tuned for, you know, as I say, to make it fully chromatic, but you could tune it any way you like. So the good thing about Seidel is they've got their configurator. So instead of you having to retune existing reed plates to very odd tunings in order to get this X-reed bending capability, you could go to their configurator, order the tuning you want, and then you can throw them into my housing here, and make up your own X-reed harmonica, totally, you know, to give you the scale you want. I'll be doing specialist videos on all these harmonicas, as well as the valving and the combs. So you can understand more clearly, you know, how each one works and all the possible options available. But anyway, that's my sort of general introduction to my twin diatonic harmonicas. Hope you enjoyed it.